Hi, everybody. I'm Brad Nessler. And I'm
Hi, Brad.
By the former quarterback, Kirk Herbstreit. And we'll also hear from Aaron Andrews in a bit.
Hi, Kirk Herbstreit.
Welcome to College Football, brought to you by EA Sports on ESPN. Today's game is between the Navy Midshipmen and the ECU Pirates. The city of Greenville, situated on Tar River in North Carolina, is the setting for this college football game.
That guy's insane with football rage. How y'all doing? I'm SuperPaulGames. Welcome back to Navy football. Not that those are Navy dudes. Well, then the guy wants us to know that this is their house. How awkward, they brought the same sign. Their name is really AQ. That's how you pronounce it. This is our next to last regular season game, I believe.
We're ready to bring you another incredible matchup as the season starts to wind down. We'll see which teams will be left standing after it's all said and done. For ECU, the quarterback has got to keep tabs on this outstanding linebacker.
I think we'll get a chance to see how good he really is against the run, because this offense features a great tailback.
It's time for the coin.
That's right. Watch out for Josh Biggins, our right outside linebacker.
Is brought to you by Reese's Peanut Butter Cups. The perfect combination of chocolate and peanut butter.
All right, now that they're done talking, shut up. We're going to pick heads because we like to get heads. We are 9-0 currently. We are number 10 in the nation, ranked number 10 in the nation, according to the coaches poll at least. We're going to kick the ball off.
Number 88. Navy is ready to open this one up as they line up for the opening kick.
Skill-wise, we are really evenly matched with these guys. Record-wise, we have a way better record, but skill-wise, we're evenly matched, which shows really how weak our team is overall. Our team overall is ranked a C. I think we have a B-minus offense. Or maybe it's a B offense and a C-minus defense, whatever. But this is one of the weakest teams we've ever had skill-wise. That being said, our team just, man, they come through when we need them to. So we're going to have our linebacker blitz. We were talking about him. They're talking about him in the pregame.
Looking to throw
yeah, sacked! We shouldn't hold on to that ball forever. Right, you for the win. Our end went up there and ended him. He's like, oh man, they hit me. That's right.
So the sack makes this a second and long.
Man, their fans really are not into things. They should get a little more excited. Make some noise. Come on, Brick, somebody get to there. Well, that was bad. It could have been worse, but that was still bad.
Great job by the running back, and that's a gain of 9.
That makes it 37.
They're calling an audible.
Come on, get that pressure. Get him. Man, 24 knows how to make some dance moves. But either way, it doesn't matter. We stopped them. Good job making him go three and out defense. It's like, oh, I have to poo. I'm sad.
Fourth down. The punter comes
up. Come on, get it to Sheamus. Let's get Sheamus a good run. Let's actually protect him for a change. Wait, not to block 28. Well, screw yourself.
Great job of getting downfield and making.
I can't believe they didn't block at all. Is Jameis still out? Oh my god, Jameis is still injured. That sucks. Hopefully he's back at least before bowl season. Ah, nice run by Hartman. Seven runs. Six is seven. Jameis has been like probable forever and just not back. I love him. He's our best guy on the team. But he gets injured a lot. Alright, 10. I'm looking at you. All right, we're changing that back. Come on, Hartman. Third and one.
Maybe a few, but that's it.
Get your defense sign out of here. The only defense you need is a strong Navy to protect you from our enemies. Foreign, I say domestic, but there aren't a lot of domestic guys who are going to hurt you via the water. People are going to come over from Wisconsin and attack me here in Michigan. I'm not too worried about that. Maybe it should be, I don't know. Weir, come over here. the stack up on this side. There you go. First down. He's going to eye fuck your pirate too. Teach him a lesson. He'll see it coming. Gross. Alright, Dynamite Sack. I'm going to be looking at you. We're going to do a play action here. What the fuck? I think I hit the wrong button. That's not who I was trying to throw it to. I was trying to throw it to Dynamite Sack, but I think I hit the wrong button.
Second down, 10 to go.
He's square, right? I swear I hit the right button. Suspicious. All right, Hartman, it's all you.
Another run.
Yeah, get that first down. What's up now, ECU Pirates? The Navy always defeats Pirates. I'm not a talking coach. I'm more of a pointing and yelling coach.
First down, 10 to go.
Weir broke his toe. Crap. I've done that before. That sucks. Poor dude.
Back to pass.
Well, that worked out well. We're going to let him rest. He broke his freaking toe. I mean, I know you can still go out there with a broken toe, but it's not the best idea.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 40-yard line.
I broke my toe at work long ago when I worked in a bakery and a giant stack of pans fell over and landed on my foot. Wish I would have had steel-toed shoes then. Oh, no! Oh, that was a bad pass.
He's got the kind of jets you need to be a standout corner.
Well, I'm not such a fan of that, and that's my own fault.
First and 10, ball on the 27.
Sorry, defense.
He looks to throw on first down.
Oh, fuck these purple people. Rick? Oh, Mirth. Get your cock blocking ass back here. Man, they love their no huddle. Their no cuddle offense. I need some cuddles, yo. Well, that's where I was trying to go with Mritz, but I got double teamed. Come on, bring it up. Scare them that we're going to blitz. Aha, he got scared so much for your screen. He's like, oh no, they might touch me.
All over the place on that play and left the quarterback nowhere to throw it.
Let's see, did one of the linemen move first?
That wasn't on our side, I don't think. Who encroached? Are you serious? Mirth? Oh, I must not have seen it as I was trying to bring the linebackers up to blitz.
So they have a second and five following the penalty.
Ding dong. Crap. Yes, keep him short of that first down.
They didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all
come
over.
Come on, bring it all up.
He caught the ball.
Hopefully they don't hit Thompson.
It looks like they're going to blitz.
Come on, get him. Yes!
They'll get him for a loss. They attempt to
bad time for them to do an option. We're bringing it.
Defensive line won that battle easily.
I know, I'm enjoying this game so far. Because our special teams is really doing a good job.
It's fourth down.
Oh, maybe we should try. I'm going to mix it up. Try some different punt returns because just what we normally do, Sheamus gets destroyed. All right, that didn't work out. Yeah, Sheamus. Sheamus is like, fuck y'all.
The offense will take the field, hoping for a better result than their last drive.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
Come on, sack. Come on, sack. Well, that was supposed to be sacks, ball. That's who I was throwing it for, but Ten Lassell is like, yoink, it's mine. That's not bad as long as somebody comes down with it. Cedric takes a shot and getting that off. We probably got an extra yard or two, though, because then Dynamite Sack ended up blocking. Hell yeah! Enter the Acid Goat. I think he started his breakdance move, then kind of got stuck. It's like, I meant to do that. It's kind of funny. I'm thrown to the Dynamite Sack, and Ten Little Soul's like, I got a coach! All that matters is succeeding.
From their own 38-yard line, first down.
Come on, get that in there. Yes, weird, getting the feet down. Despite the fact he broke his toe earlier. Man, it's throwing a strike there. Nice job by Eccentric. We really need to win this, though. If we lose, we're going to drop so far down because ECU is not ranked.
First and 10, ball on the 41.
What's up, Pirates? More like the Butt Pirates. Burn, baby, burn. Disco Inferno.
Runs right for a nice game. A pickup of five. That brings up second and five.
He is the heart man because he stole all of our hearts. Literally.
We've got
that's a crazy counter play. Like, you gotta form the letter four before you can be where you need to be. Oh, I should have followed the fullback. I wasn't quite used to that play. Oh, Ten Lassell! I thought you were going to have that. Fuck it, we're going to go for it.
Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down.
All right, here goes nothing. Ten, would you get set, please?
Flags are all over the place.
Oh, who went? Oh, sweet, encroachment of the defense. Yes, Travis Green got too excited. If it would have been our guys, I would have punted it at that point. So we're going to get out our fatty team. They love being called that. Try and give it to the fullback.
So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field.
Hartman, see if you can bring anybody with you. Oh, all right, move, Hartman. Come on, AK-47 Army, hell yeah! Getting that first down, keeping that drive alive. Suck it, Pirates! The Navy's rule the sea. That's important, though, is we need to establish that we're in charge.
From the 28-yard line, first down.
Plus, it's keeping our defense off the field, letting them get rested.
He'll get the call again. Gets out to around the 18.
Second and inches. I love that.
That'll make it second and inches.
Hartman, you should have farted on him. Then you could have been Fartman. Hilarious. Oh, I think we're down to our third-string halfback because Hartman needs a breather. Yep, Hayden. Still better than last game when we had third-string quarterback and halfback in at points. There you go, Hayden!
It's great when a running attack comes through for the first down like this. It makes an offense so much more versatile.
Man, I love seeing that. Looks like that guy's trying to cooter punch the cheerleader. And that's a classy way to say it. It's like the Lions' temporary offensive coordinator, Jim Bob Cooter.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. It's first down.
I think we're just going to take this into the second quarter, because I don't really like the defense they have. Plus, I want to keep that clock moving. Guess what? Almost said centric. He's like, what, coach? I meant East Carolina. I get confused by E-words. Like, oh, coach.
And we're all tied up at the end of the first quarter.
Bunch of goose eggs. Sucks for ECU. We play them every year. They must have been like, oh crap, we gotta play Navy again. They're ranked 10th in the nation right now. Fuck this shit, we're going for it. Yeah, 10 Locello! Touchdown! Hop over that little fence, that'd be cool. New school record for receiving touchdowns in a season. 10 Locello's got 7, I think, in the season. So he just set a record for Navy. And Navy's got a pretty long football history. Well done, 10.
He makes the PAT.
What is that? 7 receptions? Touchdown receptions of the season. You the man. Anchors away, son.
Adams is lined up to kick this one off.
Come on, Gomez Adams. Are you a senior? I hope you are. We need a new kicker.
Bowling from the 6. Gets to about the 24-yard line. The offense takes the field again.
I don't know why. Well, Deontay Walsh must have had that tackle. Man, 52 tackles this season and 4 sacks. That's pretty damn good for a linebacker.
The offense will start at the 24.
We all got in. Oh, he's playing middle linebacker. Lord KDB. Biggins. Oh, Kittrell. I'm a little disappointed by y'all back there.
Good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they look sharp before this one even started.
Ernst, adjust the play at the line. Quick out to his receiver. Tackle made at the 47.
Second and 5. They really love their hurry up offense. Come on, we're going to bring it. We're going to bring a blitz.
Ernst drops back to pass.
Well, that blitz was outstanding.
Thompson picks up around 5 yards.
So very proud of that play right there.
Drops back to pass.
Man, another blitz. Oh, yes! Way to knock it out of his hands. I wish he would have come up with it, but that's a big loss for them. What the hell? That was unsportsmanlike conduct. He tried to spike it a 99. Josh Biggins. At least I think his name's Josh, right?
It's second down and a long way to go. Ball on the 49-yard line.
Come on, guys. Oh, shit. Man, I got a hand on him. Brixton just flew by. We have a little guy playing lineman right now because of the audible with how much these other guys like to shit. Not how much they like to shit, how much they like to do no huddle.
If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to
nice job, Zassi. How about a zone punt? Maybe that'll work a little better, or a punt defense?
Brown to punt. He drops it.
No, pick it up, Sheamus! He was amazed that people actually were going to block for him, so he quit looking at the ball. Like, if he could have caught it, he could have had a bunch of yards because that whole left side is wide open. And he's just like, what? People are blocking? Damn it, Sheamus. I was surprised too, man, but still.
They'll go to work at the 15. It's first and 10. Back to pass.
Oh, McDonald! He had a farm! Fuck-fuck-fucky-o! God dang it. Sencik throws what should be a nice pass, for a big first down, and he just drops it. Third and seven, trying to make it third and manageable. I'm still a little hot about McDonald dropping that pass he should have had. Usually McDonald's a really reliable receiver.
Third down and seven. Ball on the 19-yard line.
Come on, we need a big first down right here.
Navy is up seven.
Yeah, nice shot by Rice Aroni, the San Francisco tree. You're the man, bro.
Sometimes the defense are a little bit confused on how to handle it.
Well, we just had guys do, like, you know, a crossing pattern. Oh, sex it up! He's like, I'm sexing your town. It's like, I learned it all from Sex Robot.
From their own 31-yard line, first down.
I would really, really love to get a two-score lead on these guys. Go Hartman! Yeah, sweet move! Shake and bake. He went to the ballerina school. He's like, Nutcracker, seat, sweet son! Yeah, you jazzercise. See, the thing is, Acid Goat's not celebrating. He's getting limber because... look, there's their pirate sad back there. Because we're running out of players. Like, we're running out of third string halfback. I feel like the emergency reserve should have to be the mascot. So, like, if we lose Hayden and Hartman, that, you know, Acid Goat should have to play. I think that should be... Oh, no! I think that's realistic.
Defense had great pressure there. They blitzed the middle linebacker, and there were no holes for the halfback to run through.
They're changing the play.
Huck, huck. Oh, shit. I almost got the guy. Come on. Do your little dance. Oh, just... I thought I had enough separation, but I did not. I didn't want that formation.
A huge sigh of relief because he got away with throwing what should have been an interception.
Now, I have faith in Eccentric. I don't know if we're going to pick this up, though. Third and long is a little difficult. Ten, run a streak. A streak! What? Get some steak? No, a streak! There you go. I don't know why they don't want to cover their slot guys, but I'll take it. 10 Low Soul is having a huge year. Yeah, do that Acid Goat voodoo. Voodoo the crap out of them.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 29-yard line.
All right, let's move it to the right. Yeah, nice job, Hartman. Picking up 4 yards. I love, too, is, like, whatever the time of possession is, we almost definitely have to be dominating it at this point.
It's the ninth play of the drive. Second down.
I mean, we are losing the turnover battle, but we're still ahead in the game, still dominating time of possession. Third and one. Let's get our jumbo fatty squad out. It probably doesn't help their morale when I call them that, but that's what they is.
Well, they'll line it up again on third down. Two for two so far on this drive. Their last trip down here was a success. Let's see if this one will result.
Come on, AK-47 Army. Oh, you got it. Come on. Second wind. Fourth and inches. But. Well, we all know our kicker is horrible. I wish we had a QB keeper out of, like, this formation.
The offense is still on the field. Navy is up by a touchdown.
Well, our kicker sucks, so... There we go. Good job by the offensive line. I'd like to assume that I said that right next to the kicker, and there's a single tear going down Adams' eye. face. Like, yeah, I like you and all, Adams, but you pretty much suck at kicking.
From the 12-yard line, first down. Navy up 7 points.
We would love to make that another touchdown.
And they get nice yardage on that one. More yards gained.
Not to mention the fact that we want to keep that clock just running as much as we can.
Second down and 5. This is the 13th play of this drive.
I want Weir. Get over to the other side. Let's get us some more protection. Oh, get out of my way! Don't protect me from myself.
They got 4 yards on that one.
Alright, Hayden, the third string halfback, is in.
And this is the 14th play of the drive.
Third and 2. Trying to draw them off sides. We're going to let that clock run down as low as we can. I mean, we've got all the timeouts in the world, so we can burn them if we need to. Come on, Hayden. Touchdown! Woohoo! Yes! He's like, get loud! Other team fans. What's up, Pirates? You should have been good and obeyed the law. And it's good. Hell yeah, I like this 2-score lead. I want to take that into the half. This is certainly the way we want to play in our next to last regular season game. I want us a good bowl game. There's still so many undefeated teams, though, with tougher schedules, that it's very unlikely we'd get to go to the national championship. But we could still get one of the top 3 bowl games, hypothetically.
This drive will start at the 26-yard line.
Your mom will start in my pants. How you feel about that? Ooh, yeah! That was some good pressure. Feels good when you knock those guys down.
It's second and 10. Ball on their own 26.
Come on, get the pressure again. Woohoo! He's like, man, it's not coming from one way, it's coming from another. Third down.
From their own 26-yard line, it's third down.
Come on. Slow him down.
Makes it and he's tackled short.
We're going to burn a timeout there. Take a risk again with our punt safe zone.
Fourth down. They come out in a punt formation.
I don't know if we're going to be able to do anything, but it's worth a shot. Block, you fucker! Block!
Got the corner.
Damn it. Why you always got to scare Sheamus like that? He's like, I might block. I might block. Okay, I did.
They ran the ball extremely well on their last drive, and until this defense figures out how to stop it, I think they'll have no problem moving the ball down the field.
We kind of need a miracle right here. Oh, if they don't cover balcony or 10 right, we might get it. Oh, balcony, you son of a... Come on, man, on the balcony show. Normally, he's better than that. I can't believe he didn't come down with that. That would have been huge. That would have got us close to field goal range.
He may have changed things up here. Drops back to pass.
It was a good pass.
Had a tough time with a blitz on that one.
With this guy, you can't.
Oh man. Fuck it. We're just gonna hurl it deep. Oh, if they're going
to
leave it open, go Centric!
The ball pops free. I really thought the defense had a chance to get their hands on it. The ball went out of bounds first. That's got to be disappointing.
They didn't have anybody spying the quarterback, and so he went. What a What do we do? Do we try for the field goal? We're on the 33. That's a 50-yarder. There's no fucking way our guy can hit it. 41 was this long, and he barely made that. So we might as well just throw a Hail Mary into the end zone. Oh, shit. That doesn't really matter. It was worth a shot. I should have been eccentric playing his feet more, but that's all right. Not great for his stats, but it's totally worth it in that situation to try it. Suck it, ECU. You are losing by 2 scores. And don't we get the ball back in the next half?
I believe so.
Yeah, the Navy fans who are here are like, fuck yeah, Navy rules. There is one game stat I would like to look at a quick second. I would like to see time of possession. Obviously, we're winning and everything with turnovers. Time of possession, we more than double them.
We're ready to start the second half as the teams are lined up for the kickoff.
And that's doubly good because they started the first half of the ball. All right, Seamus Melroy, you are the man.
And he's tackled at the 24.
Not bad.
So let's see how the defense will hold up now.
Wait, no. We don't need to be stupid here. We can be. It's probably better just to run the damn ball.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 24.
AK-47 Army. Yeah, okay, move over to the block. Yeah, go, Hartman, go!
Gets to about the 27-yard line. 3-yard pick.
That's why I love doing football LPs. They're the only LPs that can do that. Like, when I'm doing a visual novel, it's not often I can be like, yeah, go, go!
From their own 27-yard line.
Same thing with most war games. Or if I do in war games, it's mostly like, no! Why won't you go there, you bastard? Well, somebody didn't block right there. McDonald, we're going to take a shot here. Oh, no.
That's exactly how they drew.
They had a good blitz there. I did not like.
Now they get the ball back.
It's fourth down. The punter comes on the field.
I believe this is our first punt of the game, isn't it? Oh, yeah, because we've had turnovers in the other situation or scores, so it's not terrible.
Boland takes it to 36. He really didn't have any room to work on that punt return.
Yeah, but his blockers have to do.
Nice tackle by Duke Velmax.
They didn't hold the coverage team at bay. They just let him right through.
I don't like that they have a short field, but that's our own fault. I didn't move downfield far enough. Oh, how do you like passing backwards? I love it.
That play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also.
That's because Cobain was right on the dude. It's too bad he couldn't have knocked that down. That would have been a fumble. Because he was throwing backwards.
Second and 13. Ball on the 33.
These guys have been so one-sided this game. Like, if they would just run some, they'd have a much easier time setting themselves up for stuff. How did you catch that? Come on, defense. We got two guys there. We pressured the quarterback. And yet you're still like, oh, I'm just going to watch. That kind of failure does not make me happy, to say the least. Oops. Come on, defense. You got to step it up a little bit. Man, I like it. We had only one guy there, and we were still able to stop the screen with the one guy. That was Zassi being on the ball. Oh, that wasn't bad of them. Oh, picking up us! Oh, why did we do such a bad job? We had all our guys there. We were like, oh, oh, oh. Still, really nice job punching the ball out. Great job by Biggins. Punching the ball out, knocking him back. I like that a hell of a lot.
We've got second and goal. Ball on the 11-yard line.
There you go. That was awesome. I brought a safety, but in the end, I think it was our end got it, right? There, Cantrell. Cantrell. Never pronounced his name right. He's like, that's not my name, coach. I'm like, whatever.
Third down on the 12, and they can smell the goal line.
Why's the goal line smell? That seems weird.
Ernst hasn't missed yet.
Yeah, defense! Pick it all! He's like, I'm playing hot potato with myself. Good job, click taser, knocking it down, though. That was a pretty big play. That would have been tough, though. It did bounce off of his shoulder pads.
They'll line up for the field goal.
Yeah, if they're going to fake it.
This will be a 30-yard field goal attempt. He gets it up.
Wow. Their kicker's not great either, but he did make it. If you saw I was in a more normal defense, I was like, just in case they fake it. I doubt they would, but it's hard to block that anyway. Oh, the Pirate's finally happy. He's like, arr, arr, arr.
ECU gets set to
kick. I'm just proud of the defense that we held them to a field goal there after a few plays that did not come out very well.
He's to the 20.
Good return by Sheamus.
Their last drive resulted in a punt, so let's see if they can put together something a little more promising here.
Come on, dude.
Nice gain as he works the right side.
There we go. Keep that clock going, even if it's not the prettiest gain ever. He's like, I want a beautiful gain.
It's second down, 6 yards to go.
I should encourage my team to go poop on the midfield logo. That seems like a good idea.
He's looking to pass.
Come on, Ten Lasso, outrun that guy. Oh, man, 59, that linebacker or whatever could keep up with him.
Not risking a big gain. Instead, he just batted it down.
Well, Hartman, it's all up to you. We need a big run. I'll admit, I wasn't sure if that was going to work. 6 yards is a lot to run for, but our offensive line has done good with runs this year, and whoever's run for us, Jamez obviously has done the best, but Hartman's come through and others have as well.
From their own 40-yard line, first down.
Come on, Balcony, show you owe me a catch.
He's rolling right. He's under pressure.
Oh, that didn't work. I didn't like what I saw there, and I didn't want to be stupid.
That makes it second and ten. So it's second and ten. Ball on their own 40.
Oh, wait, I better not run this play, because every time I do this play, McDonald runs into our guy.
Looks to pass.
Oh, just too far out of him. God butts it.
He needs to get it together or the defense is going to start cheating up on the run.
Come on, McDonald. We got to get you a ball.
Back to pass.
Oh, fuck it. You can do it, eccentric. You can do it. Yes. Man, eccentric making his feet work. And he's mad about it. He's like, I'm not taking a knee. I'm not sliding. What is that? You get that from the 1920s? Like, I learned it from my flapper girlfriend. Do the Charleston. Man, Acid Goat is in way better shape than I am.
First and 10. Ball on the 48.
I think these East Carolina Pirate fans are starting to get a little worried because they're getting really quiet here. Go, Hartman, go! Yeah, their defense has given up yards. That's a great answer. And I think one of their guys might have got hurt there. Either that or his pride got hurt. You the man, Hartman.
Here's the eighth play of the series. First down.
You want to bring it? All right, we're going to run right at you. Bring your damn blitz.
Hands off and not much room there as they try to work the
left. It's still 3 yard gain, and we are just milking that clock. We're going to get Hayden to come in here.
Wasn't much room for the running back to work with.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. It's second down.
Come on, are you going to bring everybody up to try and face our jumbo package?
On the ground with the tailback. Aiden gets 6 yards on the carry. That'll make it third and one.
I don't want to say anything too good, because I want to be... What I was really thinking, honestly, is like, man, it looks like we're really dominating and are in control of this game. And we've not had many games this year where we've been that way. Hut, hut! Someone's got a big butt. Aw, they came over for a kiss. That gets us a free first down. Thanks, defense. You guys are awesome. Merry Christmas to you, too.
From the 19-yard line, first down.
No, let's switch. Can we run it to the left? Whatever. That's what Coach Ball's like, just, yeah, whatever, man, just do it. Man, people are getting tired on our team, probably on theirs, too.
From the 19-yard line, second down.
Eccentric, you should be ambidextrous. Ambidextrous. It'd be nice to have a lefty on this play when we're rolling out to the left. Oh, shit, nobody's open.
Didn't see anybody open downfield, so he took it himself and picked up some decent yardage.
We'll give it to AK-47 Army.
Ball on the 12-yard line.
Unfortunately, the play clock is just like half a second, or the game clock. Yeah, the play clock's half a second ahead of the game clock. Otherwise, I'd just let the timer out. Yeah, did we get the free play? I don't think we did.
Takes it up the middle for another.
Doesn't matter. First down.
What impresses me is the blocking up front, just man-to-man. They're able to create a lane there and get the first down.
You could, if you look back at that, you probably saw it as one of the defensive tackles jumped early, but he got back in time. It's all right. We're going to take this to the fourth quarter. What's up now, East Carolina? Nothing could be finer than to beat you in East Carolina in the morning. That's probably afternoon. 14-3.
Navy trying to go up by 3 scores.
Navy trying to crush them with time of possession. That's what we're really trying to do.
He's taken down around the 4-yard line. He gains a couple of yards on the carry.
And you've got the experience that this safety has. You can read plays very quickly and be in just the right position to make a stop near the line of scrimmage.
Hopefully the wide receiver doesn't run into him for once. We will see. Yes! Go Hartman! He still did bump into him, but it worked out. He's like, slow down a second, Hartman. Get them thinking. And it's good.
So we take a moment here. Let's check out the drive summary.
Next week's game, I believe, is our last regular season game. And if so, that means we'll be playing our arch rival Army next week. I'm looking forward to that. Not that this game is necessarily over, but if we have a really good defensive stop, we probably can end it.
He'll return it from the 6. And he makes it out to about the 24-yard line. 3 points was the result.
What we need to do is what we've been doing is a three-man front and then blitz the linebacker on whichever sides are weak. Because they've been so addicted to passing all game. Oh! Dang, Zassie, I wish you could have come down with that, man. Gotta buy you some sticky gloves.
Probably a pick he should have made.
We can gamble big time at this point with this kind of a lead.
Drops back to pass.
Please take him down. Good job, Zossi. You're all over the place, man.
They grab 8 yards there. Ernst doesn't like what he sees.
Tough shit. Yeah! Great sack by our linebacker there. Go Deontay Wash. Boom! Deontay Wash doesn't even get knocked down. He just grabs him and is like, go sit down, son. That's how we do it here. Nice job. Anchors away, my friend.
It's fourth down.
Still experimenting with our punt returns packages.
Awaits the snap. It's away, short punt.
Well, their punter got scared apparently.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball.
Or he pulled a muscle, I'm not sure which. Hey everybody, we're going to pass it very deep. This isn't a draw. No way. No, we're passing it deep. Better go cover everybody.
Get out of my way, fatty.
Watch out.
It ended up working out.
Tailback picked up 7 on the draw.
I got a little too excited on that run. I should have been a little more patient. It would have worked out similar either way, but I didn't need to be up in his grill. There you go, Hartman.
Woo.
Prepare for the fisting of a lifetime. The number one fister acid goat is here to fist the fuck out of you.
The 28-yard line. It's first down.
All right, AK-47 Army, get ready to block for me. I'm going to run to the right. Oh, that's all right. Fullbacks don't usually have great hands.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 28-yard line.
Tight end should, though. Oh, fuck. Whatever.
Back to pass. Right down, right around the 22.
Nice job by Eccentric again, man. Picking up a lot of yards on the ground.
Nice job of getting some yards there on the scramble, but he needs to learn to slide to avoid those big hits.
Nah, he doesn't need to be a wuss. Shut up, announcer. Eccentric's all mad. He's like, I'm going to take these guys out. It's going to be like Brett Favre when Brett Favre used to block on plays. Oh, another first down. How about that, ECU? What we really need to do here, is just continue to milk the clock. We'll give it to AK-47. All right, me.
Another trip to the red zone. Last time, it resulted in a touchdown.
Push him! Push him all!
Hand off, and he's mad at
me. Oh, whatever.
The fullback back to the original line of scrimmage, and that's it.
What other plays do we have in here? This might be a great time to learn some plays we don't normally run. So that if we need them at some point, we'll have had a little bit of experience with them. I didn't like what I saw, so I wasn't going to lateral it. But still, 3rd and 7's all right. I'm more than happy to settle for a field goal if we need to.
And they'll look to convert here on another third down.
Well, let's see if they overcommit on this or not. All right, 4th and 6.
Good call by the defensive coordinator. He guessed run. When the offense came with it, his guys were in position to make the
score. What are y'all going to do? You know, actually, I might just run it here. I wasn't actually going to use this play, to be honest. I was just going to wait and call a timeout, but fuck it. We got a chance with a tight end. Oh well. This game was it wasn't the best call ever, but it doesn't really matter.
Anytime you're in a situation like this, take the points and build up the
We don't really need the points though. I mean, don't get me wrong, it would have been nice to have, but
say that he should have kicked the field goal, but I thought that was a no-brainer to begin with.
Yeah, get him right there. Perfect. We got this game. Oh, just take him down in bounds. That's all we need. Please, someone take someone else down. Nope, none of that. Get out of my house. Oh, though we're actually in their house. Good job by Brian Jean. Man, this game feels so nice. We had like three or four games in a row where we barely won, and to have a game where we more or less dominated. Oh, that was a great job. I think he's still in bounds though, isn't he? Where we more or less dominated. Dude, get back here! Uh-oh. Aren't we missing somebody?
Back to pass.
Uh-oh. I know somebody was supposed to be on him.
And he's taken down at the 20. And that play could have gone for six.
Oh, boy, you're right. And all week long, this secondary did a lot of talking about...
Timeout. Somebody's not back.
I think this is time that they step up and prove it on the field. Forget about talking trash. Let's see how they react after giving up that big play.
Oh, I scared the guy, but he still got the pass off. Oh, well. Oh, what? They didn't want us to look at the stats? Who the hell's not back? Oh, that quarterback was so scared of everybody coming that he threw a rocket out there. He's like, oh my god, they're going to murder me, bro. You don't even know.
Play number 9 of this current drive. They might be coming here. Ernst drops back to pass.
Uh-oh. Oh, that doesn't really matter.
And so he found his receiver for the score.
And the closer you get to the end zone, the more difficult it becomes to throw the football because the field becomes much smaller to work with. But they did a very nice job there to come up with the touchdown.
Where was the coverage?
Yeah, those are points that really don't matter at this point. I mean, I'd rather they didn't get them, but all we care about is the win.
They try for the two-point conversion.
Brick says, no two-point conversion for you! Pirates is like, oh, fuck, arr. I knocked myself out. They're bound to do an onside kick here. Nice job by On the Balcony Show! Hell, that was good, and he got even more yards. Great field position.
Special teams. So now it's up to the offense to take care of the ball and chew up the clock.
You the man on the balcony show. I was afraid we were going to fuck that up. Oh, how about a first down? How you Pirates like that? I thought you guys were, like, supposed to try and stop us from getting yards. No?
Ball on the 17-yard line.
Well, that actually worked out just fine.
The offensive line has got to do a better job of making space because that was just...
I don't think the announcers realize what's going on. All that matters at this point is that we score. I mean, keep the clock going.
Drops back to pass.
Somebody held. Well, Kevin Hampton, that wasn't really necessary, was it now?
He drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
Yeah, I know, Acid Goat. Don't yell at him. In a time when we're just trying to run out the clock, that is so not necessary. Yeah, Hartman, keep going. Punch that ref in the nuts. Teach him a thing or two.
Third down and 12.
So ECU has used this last timeout. Regardless of whether or not we get a first down, we can take the clock down to like 20 seconds or something.
Takes the ball right.
Oh, Hartman! Holy crap. It's got to suck to be them today. Look at that blocking. Yeah, poop all over their field. Disrespect the massive goat. Take a big old steamer. The way I look at it, ECU, is you guys disrespected us by scoring that last touchdown. That was rude. Time to return the favor. Touchdown.
That's his 10th rushing touchdown of the year.
Think about how much pressure it takes off the offense and the offensive coordinator, knowing that you've got a go-to guy like this when you need a score.
That's pretty good that Hartman has 10 rushing touchdowns for the year, considering he is the backup. Oops, I didn't mean to do that. We're not going for two. And it's good. Now, we definitely won this easy.
Navy, ready to kick this one off.
Unless they had the most miraculously depressing 46 seconds ever in football. Feels good, though. We're going to go 10-0. I did not think at the beginning of the season we were going to be undefeated. He licked what now?
Nasty. This quarterback just picked apart the defense. This offense needs to continue to produce on the scoreboard because they're still losing this game.
My guy Brick just fell down.
Oh, man.
Man, good job by Zossie sticking with him. I hope next year our defense is a lot better because we have a lot of guys this year who are young and fast but not very aware. If they can get that awareness up, we got a lot of speed on defense. It doesn't help everybody falling down like that, though. Man, he spiked that fast. I think he was afraid of getting knocked down again. Oh man, Mirth got knocked down.
Wideout makes the first down catch. And he's brought down at the 34.
Defense, you guys get no Twixes if they score on you.
Spikes the ball.
You know what, fuck it, we're gonna call timeout and let our defense rest.
Second down, 10.
Why not? Our defense is all tired. Try to encourage or increase the chance that actually stop these bastards.
Looks to pass.
Man, he had all day.
They'll bring him down to the 21-yard line.
I like the call here by the defense to bring the heat with the outside linebacker. It was just a better call by the offense, and that's why it's a first down.
Well, they got free 5 yards because Brick didn't get his butt. Oh, Murth didn't get his butt back in time.
Just a
oh wait, no, that was Brick. Never mind. My bad.
Good situation for the offense here now as they have first and five.
These are really, they don't matter the points though. I mean, I'd rather they didn't score. Oh, Brick, I just fell down.
He drops back. It's complete.
Come on, three. Oh, wait, I forgot because of the first down. All right, they got time for probably one more play.
Second down, and they're only 6 feet away from 6 points. They're crowding the line.
Oh, shit. I didn't expect that.
He's taken down.
Oh, we stopped him. Hell yes. That's more of a moral victory and a crushing of them. Suck it, East Carolina.
That's going to do it for this one. Our final score, Navy 28, ECU 9.
I wish they'd do a replay of when 10 grabbed Dynamite Sacks pass. 28-9. You don't see that score all the time.
Now it's time to present the Reese's Perfect Play of the Game, which is brought to you by Reese's Peanut Butter Cups, the perfect combination of
chocolate. Ken Soul setting the season record for Navy.
On paper, there wasn't a lot separating these two teams. It was a well-deserved win. Navy came to play today and deserved some praise. They were well-prepared and well-coached.
You hear that, team? I'm well-coaching you. You're going to talk about
great effort today by this young man, leading his team to a win and, in the process, earning Player of the Game honors. For Navy, this undefeated juggernaut stays perfect for another week. They're 10-0 and sitting pretty in the title chase. And for ECU, they dropped to 3-8 in what has been a very disappointing season. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 11. Thanks for being with us. For my partners Kirk Herbstreit and Aaron Andrews and EA Sports, Brad Nessler saying goodbye.
That was a fun game. The one thing is, if we get a good bowl game, we might get crushed because we're going to be so overmatched talent-wise. But 10-0, I cannot still believe that. 10-0 is amazingly awesome. I love that. Undefeated. We just got to beat Army, and, well, I don't know if we'll beat Army or not, but we should be able to because there's no way their team is better than ours. Maybe as good, most likely a little worse. And then we just got to hope some other teams lose. Let's look at the player stats a second before we head off. Centric in Texas had a really good day. The two picks weren't a big deal. One was a bad pass. One was just taking a shot at the last second. But, you know, good passing yards. I'll take that. Really good rushing yards by a Centric, 50 yards. Hartman, 182. Hayden, the AK-47 Army, did decent. Man, AK-47 Army, the fullback in a 3-yard average. I like that. Look at all the people that had passes thrown to them. They didn't all catch them, but still four different guys caught passes, and we'll fly over to the defense. Man, Velmax, 8 tackles. Good game all around. Well, everybody, thanks so much for watching. Next week will be the last regular season week. Of course, we should have a bowl game with the way our record is, unless something goes horrible, horrible. Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. Army! Our natural rival. I'll see you all then. Bye.